Zig Isaac. You Zag Isaac. I am your sidekick. Yosh.
I wish to speak to you. Allow us to access what lies beneath all this dust. Were lost because this ship never launched, but it was built for a reason. else use this. I would like a chance to talk to you, if you are able.
Dr. Judith Tatienne, the recent delivery from Mars is unsettling. I was expecting rock samples or maybe fossils of microbial life. Instead, Dr. Victor Eiser comes with two members of the military. Everything they've brought back is under wraps. What could a theoretical physicist need with a sample from Mars? Station log. Dr. Judith Tatienne, I've been trying to cozy up to Dr. Eiser, Victor, to see what is going on. His team has completely commandeered one of the labs with those two military handrails, checking who comes in and out. I joked that maybe he found a little gray man and was doing an autopsy, and he grew very pale. 2 days later, he sends me a request asking for more information on my background in material science, metallurgical engineering. Oh, we have a meeting tomorrow. I think I'm being invited into the lab. Station log, Dr. Judith Tatienne. I have never been so nervous since I defended my dissertation. 4 hours talking to Victor and his team about theoretical metals, atomic bonding, even a half hour divergence into magnetism that I'm pretty sure was just to throw me off the trail of what we were actually talking about. Then I got to see the lab. I don't know how much I should say, but the periodic table just got thrown out the window.
Thank you.
wish to discuss with you. When you have time.
Something wrong with the math? I think it's quite straightforward.
That's not what I'm asking. We've had no success extracting even a sample of material from the object. No explanation for the gravitational effects, no motion graph to explain its harmonic frequencies. I can't even establish a melting point.
Judith.
But you've had me building these prototype colliders for months. And now you want me to pump helium-3 into it based on this equation you've written on a goddamn napkin?
I just need you to trust me.
I have been trusting you. We keep slamming our heads against a brick wall, getting nothing. And you keep coming up with something new to try. Like, you know what's going to happen. Where are you getting your information, Victor?
I'm sorry, Judith. Look, not here, okay? Somewhere off base. I'll tell you everything. But I'm not lying, okay? We're going to discover something important here. I promise.
Thank you.
early testing for planetary habitats. The looks on their faces if we could show them all that we have learned.
Thank you.
what you must. Bosco would see his likeness in this model.
Can we speak for a moment?
I never had the patience.
Project log. Dr. Victor Issa. We turned on the prototype today. The gravitational field around it began to fold as we long suspected. Completely. complete reversal of gravitational pull was observed on dozens of loose objects around the lab. I'm setting up a meeting with the directors to propose a larger test. The prototype proves we don't need the original anymore, but further work is going to have to take place in space. Somewhere with abundant helium-3 and with a civilian partner. Someone with access to large-scale manufacturing resources and computational equipment. Engineering gravitational folds pulling the far side of the solar system closer to us? It's all going to be possible.
Project log, Dr. Judith Tatien. I watched the gravjet test from the moon today. It was the first time we were able to talk to the team at Nova Galactic directly. So many things were under wraps before, but now everyone wants all the publicity they can get. I'm already seeing proposals for manufacturing androids of drives, expeditions to Alpha Centauri and beyond. It's also overwhelming and worrying. It could take years. Decades before we know what all these side effects of operating a grav drive can be. But no one wants to hear that right now. Like a bunch of pioneers racing towards the edges of the frontier without knowing about the grizzly bears in the mountains.
Can we speak for a moment? Yes?
Thank you.
never actually got to visit your labs back when we were working on the grav drive projects. Seems like ancient history now. Only thing we're doing these days is launching weather satellites. Guess this is as good a retirement as any. Now, Project Demeter, you want our help manufacturing scanners to better track these new meteorological patterns we're seeing.
Our guess is that the poles might be naturally shifting, causing some gravitational fluctuations that are throwing off our old models.
Why do you need the scanning tolerances to be so small? What are you trying to find? I just want to be sure. It's not like we're doing much these days anyway. The glory days are over. Why not give ourselves a challenge before they write us off in the history books?
I know what I'm seeing, Victor. The data coming back from the satellites is very clear. It's the grav drives.
All those jumps from the moon. At this rate, Earth's atmosphere is going to start sputtering out into space.
Can the drives be fixed?
I'm working on some designs that should discreetly solve the problem, under the guise of an emergency update to the fueling pumps.
We're talking about the end of Earth, and you're trying to be subtle about it.
Judith, the last thing we need is people losing faith in grav drive technology. That might be our only option.
To what? Are you seriously saying we should abandon Earth?
The timeline is under 50 years. A blink of an eye for a planet, but more than enough time for a human exodus.
And what do we tell people?
We say it's an act of God, one that science has found a solution for. Time for humanity to take its place in the stars.
You know, didn't you? You lied to me. All this time, I dedicated my life to this discovery, Victor. And you knew we were going to kill off our planet?
You haven't seen the future I've seen. There's an infinite expanse of promise out there. A meteor could hit Earth, a plague, another world war. Colonizing other galaxies secures humanity's future for all coming generations, across all time.
At the expense of our home!
Stop it, both of you! All that matters is building enough ships to get everyone off this planet. And we need to start now.
I'll draft up a statement. We'll need to address the entire international community. Sorry, Judith.
There isn't a planet in this universe that will be far enough away from you, Victor. We are never speaking again after this is over.
My name is Dr. Victor Issa. And if you're listening to this, then you probably already know the truth. I was young when I first headed the retrieval team of an odd gravitational anomaly on Mars. But I kept what really happened that day hidden from everyone except one other person. Even she didn't believe me at first. But I have no reason to lie to anyone now, so I hope you'll accept this confession, whoever you are. When I touched the anomaly, I experienced 12 days of lost time. I met myself. He told me everything that has since come true. The grav drive equations, the tests on the moon, Earth's atmosphere sputtering away because of what we had done. But he also told me about a city thriving on a planet orbiting a distant star. Human culture, art, music, lifestyles evolving and shining brightly across all of space. What price would I be willing to pay for that future? Maybe you don't believe me. Maybe Judith was right and I'm just a coward who wants to believe his mistakes were justified. But everyone has forgotten about the real origins of the grav drive, this artifact from Mars. I hope you make better use of it than I did.
Thank you. artifacts, grav drives, our very existence here in the settled systems. How did we not see it before now? to talk to you, if you are able.
Now that you have retraced Earth's destruction once again, do you feel any differently about it? Do you see how dangerous the artifacts can be in the wrong hands?
The Emissary trying to guilt-trip you for all eternity. That's the true crime here. The artifact led to the grav drive, which led to the settled systems. Earth was a small price to pay.
Every grav drive in the settled systems was built on technology that came from an artifact that was discovered on Mars. But these early drives shook the gravity field surrounding Earth. Eventually, the atmosphere started to slowly sputter away into space. That's why Earth is uninhabitable. The artifact gave the scientists a greater understanding of time and space, but not the wisdom to see where that would lead.
The settled systems wouldn't exist without the artifacts, in other words. We owe what happened here in NASA a great debt. Assuming we weren't going to lose it anyway. War, disease, famine, all the classics.
Don't you see? The power of the artifact forced humanity to the stars. They didn't get to make a choice. How many would have chosen Earth? And what gave Victor Issa the right to choose for them?
Are you getting tired of hearing this yet? Because I know I am. Every universe, it's the same speech.
In the wrong hands, the power of the artifacts can make anyone a tyrant. That's why we watch over them. The only thing you're watching out for is yourself. Join me, old friend. We can collect the final pieces together.
Oh, no, you don't. You're not his old friend, remember? You're from another universe. Don't try to manipulate him. Disagree with me all you want, across every universe, if you wish. But we don't always have to be enemies. Look at how far you've come. The Unity is responding to you. I know it. Your goals and mine are closer than you might think.
Thank you.
Well, can't say I didn't try. We'll settle this at the usual place.
The buried temple. We'll be there.
You're lucky I'm a man of my word. I'll see you there.
Stay for a moment. We should talk through our next steps. We won't be able to go to the buried temple right away. There are still other artifacts out there in the settled systems that haven't been gathered. You'll need to work with your colleagues in Constellation to find them. There's always a final artifact in a specific temple. Hunter and I agreed that whoever you sided with, the other would wait there. Expect anything and everything. Other starborn, human mercenaries and defenses, alien creatures under mind control. It's all fair game. He and I made a number of agreements over the years, if you can even call them. We let him go. In exchange, he'll wait at the buried temple. You'll be able to prepare any way you can before then. I'll meet you in orbit above the buried temple. We'll face what's there together. All of the other artifacts need to be gathered before the final one will reveal itself. I'll be bringing mine, the hunter will be bringing his. You'll need to bring the rest. All the ones Constellation can find. Tell me what you need.